What's up, everybody, and welcome to a special dear to my heart video. This is May, and it is Mental Health Awareness Month, and I wanted to talk to you guys about how mental health is important to me, and I feel like I need to talk to you guys about how important mental health is really, and just some tidbits on how I am dealing with my mental health and things like that. So one thing that makes me feel good when I am not in the best state in my life or just a little pick me up is doing my hair and makeup. I like to look good, okay? Even if it's looking good in the house, even if it's looking good doing 2 TikToks, even if it's looking good filming and going right back upstairs and taking it off. I like to look good. It makes me feel better, makes me feel happy, even though when I'm not in the best state of my life or the best feeling or whatever, I don't even feel like doing it. But we're gonna get ourselves together today. So first I'm going to actually put on some eye patches. So you do whatever makes you feel good. That's legal. I'm not even gonna go there. Do what you need to do to make yourself feel good, because life is hard, okay? And it's getting a lot harder. I hear gas is about to be $6 a gallon. We're gonna be riding camels at this point. I mean, I got a motorcycle license. I think it's time for me to go ahead and put that into play. Get a scooter, a bike, you know what I'm saying? Give me a sugar daddy. I mean, like, something has to give because the economy... I got to scratch my head. The economy is just pushing my limits. I got my straightening comb on, and I'm going to straighten my edges and stuff. I've washed, you know, the front of my hair a little bit. I'm going to take a drop of... of Missani Thermal Smooth and go around this part of my hair just like that. A good old straightening comb and hit these edges up real quick. Okay, so now that I have straightened my hair, I got my less expensive flat iron to curl my hair. I still like to use this edge booster stuff to kind of get my hair together. Put this on my hair because it gives me that shine that I like. And now I'm actually going to go through the motions of fixing this hair, child, okay? Well, we're gonna talk about our mental health once I get my hair curled up and pinned up, because to me it is such an important topic. I feel like, especially in the Black community, it's overlooked or it's just not even a thought. Like, people don't even wanna talk about it, or they don't address it, or the first thing they wanna say, y'all already know, we ain't crazy, or, well, that's what we got God for. We go pray on and keep moving. We gonna address that. Thank you. Okay, I'm back. That took forever, but anyway, and it's up in your kind of hook. I ain't really going nowhere. I just wanted to be a little cute or whatever. But back to the topic at hand. May is Mental Health Month. And my first tip to y'all is don't let anybody play with you. No, but seriously, people will take advantage of your kindness, of your weakness, of your ability of trying to be a Christian, or your ability of trying to keep a good job, or your ability of trying to take care of your kids, and because they know that you will bite your tongue, okay? But your mental health matters. Now, the way you address certain people can get you clocked, okay? Or get you fired, okay? Or get you broken up. So, season your word with salt. But don't let nobody play with you, because I guarantee you, they will not let you play with them, okay? But let's talk about what mental health is. A lot of people say, oh, I ain't over mental health. I don't have mental health. Everybody has mental health, okay? Your mental health can be happy, sad. If you are alive, you have a brain, you have mental health. I think what people get confused is there's a difference between mental health and mental illness, okay? So y'all hear about the mental illness all the time, the bipolar, the depression, the schizophrenic, the PTSD. Those are diagnosed mental illness. And I know y'all like to get on social media, on Snapchat and all that stuff, and y'all like to self-diagnose yourselves and stuff. I don't know what's going on in this world, but everybody wants to say they got PTSD. Everybody wants to say they got depression. And I need you all really to quit using those words in vain, because for one, there are people who actually have those things, and because it's so popular now, they're just like, I don't want to step up. I ain't trying to fit in with the masses. I don't really want a crowd to my issues. I just want to get help in silence. So when y'all be blasting, calling first in a little moment of sadness, you're like, I'm depressed and stuff, but you depressed because you got your car repoed because you didn't pay the monthly note. No, bro, you stressed. You're walking, but you're not depressed, bro. So y'all need to learn how to use these terms correctly. It is important that you know what you're talking about. Quit self-diagnosing yourself. Quit diagnosing other people because you're not a doctor. There's nothing wrong with listening to people's emotions, listening to people's problems. Most people need somebody to listen to, but you ain't nobody a doctor. Quit trying to tell people and quit giving folks your medicine, okay? Everybody don't need Adderall. I said it again, everybody don't need Adderall. Okay, so we're gonna get into mental health and things like that, but right now I'm gonna get into what makes me happy, which is doing my makeup, and I'm getting ready to do my eyebrows. And that's on period. What I am looking for is my pencil sharpener. I like this bad boy to be on point. That is the favorite part. My favorite part about this pencil is that you can get these eyebrow scales. Let's go ahead and snatch these eyebrows up. Okay, the eyebrows is together. I'm gonna snatch these eye patches off. I really love these things. I'm about to go to back to Target and get some more. But back to mental health, you guys. Mental health is so important, and here is why. First of all, I think mental health is my personal opinion. Don't clock me, don't be like blah blah blah. My personal opinion, mental health is more important than financial health, physical health. Yeah, financial and physical health. And the reason why I say that is because your financial status can change at any moment, right? You know what I'm saying? And if your mind is not in a place where it's content, where you can find other joys besides not having a lot of money, it don't matter. We seen plenty of celebrities who have money, have the things that we killing ourselves to get every day, and they unfortunately commit suicide. And the first thing we say is, oh, we don't understand why they do this. Well, you don't understand because you're not in their brain, first of all. So that's like an insult. I hate when people say that, like, wow, they should have no reason to be sad. They should have no reason to commit suicide because they have everything. They have everything but healthy mental health. That is why it's so important. These actors, actresses, singers, songwriters, dancers, writers, philanthropists, all these people had what we thought would look all together, but our reality is their mental health wasn't a healthy spot for them. And unfortunately, mental health is not something you see. You just don't see mental health. You know what I'm saying? Like, for example, if I walked into the store, right, and my arm was broke, and somebody saw me trying to open the door. Most people with some, that's got some common sense, is going to be like, oh, let me help you with the door, because they see my arm is broke. I can refuse the help if I want to. I can acknowledge that my arm is broke, right? Because it's physically there. It's something you can see. It's something you can deny. And it's something that I can choose to get taken care of. It's nothing embarrassing about it, whatever the case may be. But when you are mentally unstable, babe, sometimes you don't even recognize. You don't even know that your arm is broke sometimes. You know what I'm saying? And that could be dangerous. You can't fix what you don't see. And then on top, let's go ahead and get a little deeper. You can't fix what you don't want to see. Okay, it's so easy to hide behind things. For example, these jobs or experience, more life experiences, unnecessary life experiences, because you don't want to address the true issue at hand. You know, they destroy the good things that God has given them because they are mentally unstable, and instead of addressing it because of stigma, whatever the case may be, cost, availability, you know, time, money, where they feel like they can't address it, they jump into these situations that only mask the problem when there's really a really big problem there. And so that's why I say mental health is way more important than financial health and physical health, because there are a lot of people that's walking about, the majority of the world is overweight, you guys. I'm just gonna keep it a book. The majority of the world is overweight and still doing their thing. You know what I'm saying? Still moving, still grooving, still doing whatever. You know what I'm saying? And that's all fine and dandy, even though I do believe that people, we need to start taking our physical health way more seriously, because the world is just big for no reason and it don't have to be that way. But that's what it is, right? Most people and most Americans are overweight. You know what I'm saying? We can choose to address it or not. Some people have chosen not to, and you know, that's okay. But when you are mentally out of shape, you are still expected to show up and show out. You are still expected to work. You are still expected to be a good mom, to be a good boyfriend, to be a good husband, to be a good coworker. And there's a stigma. And I know that jobs, they say, oh, we cannot hire you because you're mentally unstable. They have all these clauses to protect people from not getting jobs because they claim to be mentally unstable. But to be honest, unless somebody says, we're not hiring you because you are bipolar or have PTSD, you'll never know. They'll just say things like, you weren't the best fit at the time. You know. And so there's this stigma, well, if I mask it well enough, then I could be able to hold that job, hold the position, to be able to take care of my family, because these jobs aren't really that keen or that kind to people who have mental health issues and really express that. And you know, even in my profession, I feel all educators should have one mental health day a month, because baby, if y'all don't know y'all kids, we do, because a lot of times educators spend more time with your kids than you do. You know what I'm saying? You think about it, we're there with them at least 8 hours a day. Then when you pick them up, you know what I'm saying, you dropping them off at daycare, drop them off at their cousin's house, drop them off at your mama's house, and we spend more time with them than you. So it is mentally draining sometimes to have to do what we do. So I always said that teachers, educators should get one mental health day a month, and I'm adamant about that. back to, I'm just doing a quick eye look right quick, real quick. I'm getting ready to put on some magnetic lashes, y'all. Aren't you proud of your girl? Well, anyway, let me put them on first and, let me touch it, okay. Let me put on this, I have this, these magnetic lashes right here. Look, already, we just gonna see, we gonna see what we can do right quick. I feel blind. Let me blend out my concealer right quick. Well, let me actually finish putting my concealer where it needs to be. Okay, you guys, I gotta get used to these lashes. But they look cute. I just feel heavy. Like, I feel like it's on me. It's on me. Okay, let me go in with my NARS. I'm gonna spill a few drops here. Oh, Lord. Am I getting low? One of my favorite foundations? I'm still gonna do something else, some more under my eyes, but I got to set under my eyes real quick. Yes. This is the Fit Me Maybelline setting powder. I've been using this a lot lately. For one, I didn't want to use my expensive setting powder when I'm just doing YouTube videos and going straight upstairs. And two, it just really works really good. It's a good alternative if you just don't want to use up, you know, your expensive setting powder. Like me, I don't even want to use it all up. Now I'm going to talk about the mental health stigma in the Black community. Black people, us, me, we, you, she, he. We have a problem with admitting that we need help, first of all. So we don't, because it's like a sign of weakness for us. But if you are weak and you need help, there's even more reason why you should get some help. I've never understood that. Oh, well, if I'm going to see a therapist, that's just showing that I may be crazy. Well, baby, you really need to go. What are you talking about? Oh, what, about think I'm crazy? What? Why are you so concerned about what everybody else thinks about you? So I feel like out of the Black community, and that just comes because we were always told that we were less than. We had to always extra prove who we are. And so, God forbid, we have an issue. You know what I'm saying? And so it makes us feel like, well, I don't want to say that. You know, I just got this good job. You know, I just, you know, got this nice husband or whatever the case may be. And I can deal with it, you know. I'll be all right. But what ends up happening is you don't be all right. You know what I'm saying? You're cheating yourself out. Like, everybody has the right to be all right. You know what I'm saying? I know we've been told that we can't. You know what I'm saying? We've been treated like we can't. But, like, forget that. Okay? You know what I'm saying? If you're not okay, like, you know the thing to say nowadays is if somebody asks you, you okay? It's not really because they really want to know. They just want to ask the question because they feel like it's the right thing to ask. I be wanting to know. And there are some people out here that really care to want to know. You know what I'm saying? Like, it's time out for the mask. I'm not talking about the color mask. But it's just time out for masking how we really truly feel. Especially us Black people. We deserve positive mental health too. You know, we've probably seen our grandparents and our great-grandparents just endure. That's because they had no choice. But we got a choice now. We really do got choices around here, and we deserve to get help. And so, if you're watching this and you're thinking, oh, well, I don't want anybody to think something wrong with me, that's why I'm not getting mental health taken care of, then I urge you to reconsider, because you deserve that. And we all do. We all do. If you're in a spot where you feel like you just can't get out of, or you know what I'm saying, like you just need someone to talk to, do it. Do it. You can never say it didn't work for you if you never tried it. And that's just my tidbit. I was one of them ones where I just didn't have the time. I didn't make the time. You make time for what you want, right? I just didn't make the time because, for one, I didn't honestly feel important enough. Like, cause I felt everybody around me is dealing with stuff. Like, what makes me any more special? You know what I'm saying? Everybody else is dealing with things too. So I'm just gonna deal with it too and keep my mouth shut. But in all reality, everybody around me is effed up. You know what I'm saying? These people are really messed up. And you shouldn't. You shouldn't be just dealing with stuff by yourself. You know, it childhood traumas, any type of trauma that you deal with and you haven't dealt with as an adult, is going to bleed into your relationships. Y'all see it all the time. These codependent relationships. I was one of them. Oh, don't leave me, blah, blah, blah. I need you. But you really didn't even love them. You just don't want, like, the fact that somebody's moving on from you. You know what I'm saying? That's toxic, y'all. That is toxic. And like black people, we use that word so much. But honestly, do y'all know how it even starts? Like, y'all just love using the word. But where does this all begin and where can it end? You know what I'm saying? Because you cannot be toxic. You don't have to be toxic. That I think that we need to stop worrying about how it makes us look as far as getting help and just go get it. You know what I'm saying? Because we deserve it. Like, what makes you think you don't? That's even a problem. The fact that you feel like, oh, I just got to endure. That's a problem because you don't have to. You really don't have to. I just want everybody to be okay with saying that you're not okay. It's okay to not be okay. You know what I'm saying? Especially with what's going on in the world today, baby. How can you? You gotta be living under a rock. I'm like, oh, life is peachy. Life is just everything. But it's not. Like, even me as a Jehovah's Witness, and you know, me knowing the conditions of the world and listening to God, blah, blah, blah. I'm like, oh, Lord, I know you said we want another time in the hour, but can you give me a hint? can you let me know a little bit? Because, Lord, they over there beating me up. They beating me up. It's getting to me. It's getting me. Okay, Lord, like, I know you see it. Like, please help. Send help. You know, send one of them angel things or something. Because, baby, we tired. We is tired, okay? And, you know, it's just only getting worse, y'all. Y'all get right with yourselves. If you're a Christian or you're a struggling Christian like myself, because I be in my own little world sometimes. But I struggle, but I am conscious of my spirituality. If you are like that, get right. Do what you gotta do. If it means cutting off people or doing whatever, do what you gotta do to get right. I'm gonna use D-Slick. Oh, wait, no. I gotta get under my eyes. Well, I'm gonna use this. I want to use this pencil. I want to use this pencil. Oh. Okay. So, yeah. And back to the whole... I had to spray my face and let me just do some setting, you know, stuff. And speaking of being a Christian, I'm going to go back to what a lot of church people say, something you've probably already heard, is that just go to God about it, pray about it. Yes, go to God about it, pray about it. But y'all do know God put these people here on the earth to help us, okay? Just pray about it, but like seriously, because faith without works is dead. Faith without works is dead. You gotta put in that work, child. Like, you can't just expect God to just put all the answers in your lap. Like, he put people on the earth to help you. Like, that is the whole point, you know? And so when people just say, oh, you don't need a therapist, you need God. Like, he put them there. What you mean? What you mean the therapist is here from him? Because he can't be all, like, sometimes you need, like, a physical human being listening ear. And he knows that because he's the grand creator. So it is nothing wrong with going to speak. So there's nothing wrong with being on medication. If you need medication, take your meds. Cause I'm going to let you know. Bro, did you do it today? Because what's happening? A little Johnny. No. Take your meds. It's all here for you. And there is nothing wrong with seeking help outside the church or whatever religion you have or religion you don't have or whatever the case may be. Nothing wrong with it. Absolutely nothing wrong.
Santa Claus.
Okay, it's time for me to take these pins out of my head. I don't even know what I'm expecting, but they're coming out. They're coming out. Okay. Hair is down. Makeup is on. I like it. But seriously, if you ain't learned anything else, if you not into the makeup, you not into the hair, now if you haven't learned anything else, please go get you some help, okay? Like, I want everybody, I'm shifting my channel to more mental health, self-care type stuff, because it is so important to me. Like, I have lost a couple of friends due to poor mental health, due to fear of stigma and being talked about and stuff, and they just never got the help they needed. We all probably personally have lost somebody due to this, and I know May is Mental Health Month, but it's every month for me. It is every month for me, literally. If I didn't seek help, I wouldn't be here right now. There is no way the things I've been through in life that I would have just got through it with God and Bengay or Benadryl or whatever. Or whatever black people be trying to say, put a Sprite. No, I would not have done that. So shout out to those who are wise enough and chose to get help. And if you are listening, you don't want to talk about it, you don't want anybody to know that you consider it, it's none of their business that you considering to get help. But make it your business to consider to get help for yourself. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Let me know your mental health journeys, positive, negative, in between, whatever. And I will see you guys in the next video. Deuces.